So, are you straight edge? Now, there's sober, that someone at some time might have gotten into the drugs and the alcohol and said, hey, that's not for me. I shouldn't have done that with a Malamute in an alleyway while a bunch of Korean businessmen laughed and threw money at me. Time to get my life in order. But then you got the straight edge. And that's the, I ain't never done it. Alcohol's never touched my lips. There's some people that go so far as to, I don't even take ibuprofen. If it is a pharmaceutical or an inebriant, it's never crossed
their
lips.
Wait, to be straight edge, you've had to have never had it?
Straight edge usually is someone that is, now there's people that are sober. But
I was going to ask, what is the difference? So straight
edge.
So if you've ever had alcohol, you can't be straight edge?
You've already lost it. As a subculture, it's usually in the punk scene. A lot of people in the punk rock scene love throwing up the X. They'll draw the X on the back of their hands. Mm-hmm. Now, and also, you know what? They don't consume caffeine. Like, that's an inebriant to them. Or that's
a drug.
It's a mental, affecting substance. So, sorry, can't take it. That's wild. And, I mean, that's a kind of a really clean way to live. I mean, as the old saying goes, hippies are awful people pretending to be good, and punks are good people pretending to be bad. And that's a pretty damn good way to live if you really think about it. You're living about as naturally as you could. But, I mean, these days, I mean, Speaks, we might as well get you an Advil endorsement, okay?
Yeah,
you keep Advil. Excedrin in business.
Excedrin, Advil, Tylenol.
Joe's back here doing lines of Midol. He's having a banger period this month.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And, yeah, I ask, 410-338-1090. I don't think any of us in here were. I've drank with almost all of you. Did you ever know a straight-edge kid?
We know one.
Who do you know?
Testoni.
What am I saying? Testoni.
Yeah, and he will let you know.
Oh, yeah, he's real proud of that ass.
He should be.
Do you think he's a pure blood, or has he had caffeine?
I think he's a pure blood,
man. Is he a pure blood?
Yeah. I don't think he drinks caffeine.
Well, he's also said that he's watched family members that have, been altered.
Oh, yeah.
But it's affected him to the point where he's like, I don't want to be that or do that.
That's the way you go. Either way, you either become that person or you go so far from that person that you're like, well, Uncle Ted falling down the stairs and headbutting the drywall looks like a blast. Let me go ahead and have some Jaeger. Or I don't feel like eating sheetrock for lunch. Let me go ahead and never ingest. And I think Nick went that direction. Damn, when's he in again?
Probably next week.
Next week?
Yeah.
We got to ask him about that.
Yeah.
I can't wait to get into the 8 o'clock hour while we're discussing this. Nerd. Hell yeah. I mean, famously, one of my favorite wrestlers, CM Punk, that was his whole bit, is he would come out to a crowd full of drunk wrestling fans. He'd throw up the X. He's got straight edge tattooed on his stomach. He'd be like, I don't poison my body with drugs or alcohol. That's why I'm better than you. The booze? I mean, you take an arena full of beer-swilling, pot-smoking wrestling fans, and you say, I don't do what you're doing right now that makes me better than you. They're like, oh, I want to see someone kick your head off. It's called good heat. Yeah, and the punk scene in Southern Maryland, D.C., a lot of them.
Yeah, I'm reading here. It is directly linked. It's subculture of the hardcore punk movement.
Yeah.
So it might be.
Val's not, because she has her pre-actors, which is sweet and low and white wine. So, she's already slipping down a satanic path. On the other side of her sports, we want to talk to you, 410-338-1098. Were you a straight edge kid? Did you go so far as to draw the black X's on the back of your hand? Remember, they would put that on your hand if you were underage. You couldn't drink at a club. They'd X your hands up. People would wear those as like a sign of pride. They'd sharpie their hands in the morning. Asking you, 410-338-1098, you straight edge? Oh, yeah. There's old Cranky Phil. He's straight edge. The only thing he gets high on is the smell of his beautiful wife, AJ Lee, and a nice muffin. Yeah, you straight edge? You know anybody that was? I actually found some info on a question you asked, Scott, about being a pure blood straight edge, as in you never have ever. Or can you become straight edge after maybe years and years of either using or abusing? And there's a whole Reddit community, just r/straight edge, and they're torn. There's some people who go, no. It's called a later life.
No.
All right. And then other people are like, no, of course you can. If you decide to live the life you're allowed to be, yes, of course you're straight edge. Let's ask the straight edge elders.
So we got a bunch of texts. We might want to call these people. Tyler in Harford County says, I've been straight edge my whole life. I have a tattooed X on my arm.
Dude,
drinking culture never made sense to me, so I claimed edge in high school. Justin, it's worth noting that the old school D-bag straight edge people are all but gone. I think a lot of the youth is waking up to the fact that drinking and the bar scene isn't what it's cracked up to be. I will agree with that. Maybe, I don't know, but I'm just trying to figure it out. Like, I see my friends, they have kids that are like drinking age now, and it seems like it's not that, that culture may have kind of gone away.
I don't, like just
the drinking bar scene. I don't know if kids are really that into it anymore.
But going out, being just drinking,
like underage drinking, getting a fake ID, going to bars, hanging out, and just drinking.
It's just doing the edibles, man. That is a thing now in the neighborhood. Teens, they still like hanging out in the woods. Big, let's head into the woods culture. But they're not like sneaking sixers of beer or steering a handle of vodka. They just have a small tin of like 5-10 milligram whatevers and still getting banged up. Where are we at? Eric, what's up? Rito Hookshot. I'm over 50. Excuse me. Some of my rum coming up. I'm over 50 and have been straight edge my whole life. The amount of people who don't believe it's possible is staggering. Yeah, because, I mean, you tell me, you know, hey, I'm straight edge. Like, oh, you're sober. Like, no, I've never done anything ever. And the first experience is, what? What, not ever? Not ever? It does have to be, you got to be kind of like a unicorn. Like one of those people that have never had COVID. You never had it? You never had it? Yeah, there's a whole thread on this thing. And some of the bands, too. Whew, boy. Yeah. Do you want to briefly get into why we're talking about this, Joe?
Yeah, for sure.
What's happening in the 8 o'clock hour?
I was in a gang.
I'm sorry, what?
I was in a straight edge gang.
Okay.
And, well, I was doing some research while we were talking about this on being straight edge.
Yeah.
And apparently, in the early 2000s, law enforcement officials started categorizing straight edge people as a gang.
Like the Juggalos?
Yeah. Well, the opposite, but sort of. So if you were straight edge hanging out with other straight edge people, you were technically in a gang.
So if you guys like passed around a fifth of Jack, you're good to go.
Right.
But if you're sitting there completely sober, like, hey, not on my watch,
yeah,
get that kid a cigarette.
Right.
Weird.
Yeah.
Was it because of the symbolism? Like the text Scott just read about getting the X?
Yeah.
This Reddit thread, it's nothing but people with that big, fat, thick-lined X either on their hands, on their shoulder, over their heart.
Yeah.
I mean, sometimes when there's some symbolism involved, for example, clown makeup, makes the feds nervous. So let's get back to you being in a gang, which we're going to get into quite a bit at 8 o'clock. Were you ever in a gang? what was the age amongst these people?
I'd say 15 to 17.
Watch out now.
Older than I would have thought.
You ever kill anybody?
No, they did nothing. We talked about it yesterday. They literally were not a gang. They were just a group of friends.
Well, that didn't do anything.
And I think, now that I'm reading about this, I think the origins of the name...
I'm sorry, the what?
The origins?
The
you are definitely not straight edge anymore.
The origins?
The origins.
You know what I mean.
Sounds like a low...
Origins?
A little known Motown band.
The origins.
Look, I'm still waking up. Give me a break.
You know what happened? You want the truth of what's happening with Joe today?
What's happening? No, it's epilepsy.
And I don't know if it's affecting him just yet, but he tried to buy some Zins on the way in, and they were out of Zin.
Are you Zinless?
I've had one in my mouth for about 3 hours. It's not doing anything anymore.
Oh, yeah. You've sucked it dry?
He's starting to go Zinless.
The gaslight. The light came on.
Yep. Yeah.
Gaslight's on.
We'll see what the next 2 hours hold.
Oh, my God. You do the whole show. The opposite of straight edge is Zin.
Yeah, I was going to say, you went complete opposite of straight edge. You are like the biggest smoker, pothead. Like,
I don't even think I was straight edge when I was in that gang.
Oh, had they only known.
No, yeah, you were definitely I think 15 to 17. You were definitely
an honorary member.
You're like the vegan that still eats chicken parm, because that doesn't count.
They just did it because it was a cool thing to say you were straight edge. No one was actually really trying to be straight edge.
No, and it was just goofy.
Every one of you were doing something 100%. Individually without telling the other.
100%.
Well, yeah. No, there was definitely a couple guys that were
hardcore.
Seriously straight edge.
Where are they now? Do you know where they are now?
No idea.
Raging
alcoholics. I know one of them eventually started drinking and partying and stuff, but one I think might still be straight edge.
I'll tell you what, you know who was straight edge his entire life? Rest in peace, Detour Dave Sandler.
Detour Dave, a teetotaler.
He never even had a drop of alcohol his entire life.
Jerry,
let alone
the King
a cigarette,
Lawler.
Let alone anything else. Like, alcohol seems the most accessible. Alcohol and smoking, right, are the two most. That guy never even, he would say, he's like, I've never had a drop of alcohol.
Did you, do you know if he drank coffee or anything? Like the, nope. Like the deep in the game
types? So.
Wow, that dude got up and kicked that much ass and never had a sip of coffee.
And he's dead, so. Yeah.